All right, guys, down here at the camp again. This is the bushcraft camp. Back, and I'm doing some work down here. So a couple of videos ago, you guys would notice I put together some big dirt mound with rocks, and I thought it was gonna be a good idea. Turns out, wasn't a good idea to build a mound out of dirt because once it rains on it, it just creates this big, muddy, slopey, slippery mess. So what I've done today is I've taken all that apart, cleared all that out, took out the logs, all the dirt, leveled it out, and then threw some leaves on top to try to kind of make it so it's not so muddy. And I'm gonna put a new fire pit a little bit closer to my shelter. It was about 6 feet out. I'm gonna bring it to about 2 or 3 feet away from my ridgepole right here. I'm gonna be doing just a basic one, like a round one that's small enough for where I can put a grill right on top. And also, I'm gonna make a new way to hang a cook pot. Something I saw on Instagram. So stay tuned and hope you guys like the video. All right, trying to get it so that the grill height will be perfect for cooking on. Don't want it too high, don't want it too low. So it's basically just like a big game of, it's a big puzzle to get this all fitting right. Ooh, that's not bad. A little wonky, a little crooked, but not bad. But that's pretty good. That is really good, check this out. Might not look like much from there. But yeah, I need to figure out a way to get it so it's not so rockety. It's getting hot out here. All right, check it out. New fire pit. All right, so it's small. You'll notice it's not a huge fire pit. It's probably, I don't know, 16 inches wide by 2.5 feet long. Perfect for my grill. I can set my grill top on top of it, and I've got these nice little flat surfaces on the ends, right here and here. I've got this rock propped up like that. So I can set stuff on it. It's almost like a little countertop, primitive countertop. But yeah, that's where I'm at. So I'm gonna gather some wood. So I'm gonna gather some wood and start putting together this new pot hanger I saw online. Super cool idea, using dovetail notch joinery to hang a pot above the fire. So right there, I can always set a pot right on top of that grill, but this is just in case the grill's full. All right, what I'm looking for is 2 straight branches, green or dry. One about hip height, probably three or four feet long, and the other one probably about 2.5 feet long. About that big around, in that vicinity. Strong enough to hold a pot full of water. I think this'll do, I think. Or the way that I'm making it is with 2 posts. One like this, showed you guys a close up. This one's about almost 4 feet long, and I'm gonna stick it in the ground. And from about here up, I kinda wanna shave it down. Instead of a round shape, we want it to be triangular. And the way that that'll hook in to the piece, the cross member, is with a dovetail joint. You guys will probably understand better once I start putting them together. So get out my axe and start chip chopping this thing up. So the ideal is to make it triangular in shape. So I'm gonna shave off one at this angle, one off at this angle now. A little bit of rot down at the end. That should be alright. Just trying to smooth it out a little bit. I feel like I got better control with the knife than with the axe hatchet. So just going over it, trying to get it nice and square and straight. Not square, but you know what I mean, flat. Alright, well, this is as triangular as I can get it. It's alright. As long as I can get some movement on the cross member, I don't need it to go all the way up and down, just maybe a foot worth of movement, then that will suffice. So just while I'm at it, I'm going to strip the rest of the bark off this just to keep the wood from rotting out anymore. You guys could already see there's some, I don't know what you call it, spalting. This stuff's already starting to, this one's already starting to rot away. So strip off the bark as best I can. And then I gotta go find a piece for the cross member. I'll get back with you guys when I'm done with this. Hoping this is big enough. Let's go try it out. So this hardwood branch that I found ended up being the right size. So after stripping off all the bark, cutting it down to the length I need, I began to saw in my triangular shaped notch using a little silky saw I had. It's kind of a tricky thing to do. It wants to roll around. There's no easy way to do this out in the woods. So what I ended up doing was setting it on top of a downed tree and using my foot to kind of brace it so it doesn't roll back and forth as much. The process of sawing down that notch is tricky because it's hard to get the right angles, but after a little bit of tinkering with it, I got a rough shape that I liked, and I began to use my knife to chip out the insides of that notch. All right, it's not the straightest notch, it's a little crooked, but it's getting close. I'm just trying to work down some of these little corners right here because the angle I cut into it wasn't the same as the triangle I carved in the other piece. So just removing a little bit of material from like right here and right here. This is where a little flex cut would come in handy. I'm gonna go get some. Alright guys, got my two components made up. They fit together all right. And then in this one, which I did the little notch, I also did this. And this is where the handle of the pot will sit so it doesn't slide around. So let's see if we can get this thing set up around the fire pit. All right, so I don't want to hammer this piece in because it's carved into a triangle. It's gonna be more brittle. I don't want it to split and ruin everything I've done. So I'm gonna find something else similar, sharpen the end, nail it, hammer that into the ground, which will create the hole for the one I'm actually using. All right, it's in the ground. Cross piece, does it work? Beautiful. Beauty. Then the pot fits like so. Put that right there. And it should help strengthen it a bit. So there's a notch. If you look up close, you'll see it's not good. It's not like a very well-carved notch, but it works. And it supports this cross piece where the pot hangs. And there's the notch. See how the notch holds the bale so that it doesn't slip? The hope is that it's strong and water weight doesn't pull it down too much. But that's it for now. That's what it looks like. Guys, camp update. Today, I bulldozed the old fire pit, put together a new smaller fire pit, and built this new pot hanging system using a dovetail notching system. I'm trying to get to more of a simplistic cooking platform. So this allows me for a small cooking fire, multitasking. I think this is gonna be good. So I appreciate you guys watching. It's about time to rain, so it's time for me to go. Till next time, Scrambled O, signing off.